Hi guys, this is Chris from Macombu reporting live from CES 2015 in Vegas, and this is the Alcatel Watch, which is the name of Alcatel's smartwatch, all in caps of course. Well, the main selling point of this thing is that it's only $149, which makes it a bit cheaper than the likes of the Moto 360 and the LG G Watch R. You'll see, like the Moto 360, it's got a nice rounded design, 1.22 inch screen. But unfortunately, it is also quite thick and made of plastic, not metal, just like the 360. But that said, it is quite light as well, so it's not too intrusive when it's on your wrist. Unlike the 360, the watch runs a proprietary OS. It doesn't run Android Wear, even though you might think so at first. It runs kind of similar to Android Wear in some respects, like you flick your finger up the screen in order to get into your notifications. But if you tap the screen, then it takes you into the apps menu. And the demo unit that we're trying here, it's got plenty of apps pre-installed. So, for instance, you can turn airplane mode on and off. You can fiddle with your music, playing skip tracks and things like that. You can there's a function that lets you vibrate and ring your phone. So just in case you lose it on the back of the sofa or the cat nicks it or something. You can test your heart rate because that's massively popular at the moment. You can check the weather if you can't be bothered to look out the window. So there's all kinds of features stuffed away in there. Nothing particularly standout, but all the sort of standard stuff that you would expect to find. Best of all, because it's a proprietary OS, that means that you don't have to run it just on an Android phone. It does support Android 4.3 smartphones and above, but it also supports iOS 7 and above, so you can use it with your iPhone as well. And another selling point of the Alcatel watch is the fact that the USB charger is actually buried away inside the strap. So if you flick this top bit of the strap, that exposes the USB connectors, and you just plug it straight into a laptop or some other USB charging device, and that'll power it right up. So there's no fiddling around with bloody annoying docks or anything like that. Unfortunately, like the Moto 360, there is a little black gap at the bottom of the screen there, which is kind of annoying. It does detract from the overall experience. And it is a real shame, but at the same time, the screen's perfectly fine for a $149 device. And we're definitely excited to play more with the Alcatel watch. So hopefully you should be coming to the UK in the next couple of months and we'll get you a full review. So check back for even more CES live coverage. And thanks for watching.